My name is Andy McNitt. I'm a professor of soil science and turfgrass here in the Department of Crop and Soil Sciences. We have a fairly large student base. They come in because they're mostly interested in golf or professional sports or collegiate sports. They have some affiliation with the sport, or they just like to be around it. Maybe they've had a little bit of experience playing Little League or working on a golf course in the summertime. About 85% of our students are interested in golf turf management, and about 15% are interested in sports field management. Our golf course management students end up interning on courses like Augusta and Oakmont and Pine Valley and Pebble Beach. Penn State has the largest alumni base in turfgrass, so you're tapping in, if you become a turfgrass science major, you're tapping into an alumni base that is very large for internships and potential job opportunities. As far as our sports turf students, they go to the NFL, Major League Baseball, or collegiate sports or minor league baseball. Right now, currently, there are a lot of jobs in minor league baseball because there's so many minor league teams being created and popping up everywhere. So not only do you do an internship there, but there's potential job opportunities. So our students like to work outdoors. The internship is extremely important. I tell students there's two ways you get a job in this industry. One is by going to Penn State and getting good grades. The second one is your experience, and so you need both. And it doesn't mean you can't get a job without experience, but you might start a little bit lower than somebody who does have experience. We have way more requests for internships, and they are paid internships, than we have students to fulfill those interns. We have essentially a 100% job placement rate once you graduate from college, and I say nearly 100, you must be willing to relocate. And you might not get the perfect dream job that you want right out of college. You have to start and work your way up. The economic downturn has hurt the industry, but it's really hurt upward mobility. It hasn't hurt the entry-level jobs. Back 10 years ago, it took you probably 3 to 4 years to become the head groundskeeper at an NFL franchise or a head groundskeeper at a golf course. Today, that might be 6 or 8 years. But the starting salary is good, and there's a large salary range. We have some golf course superintendents making well over $200,000 a year. That's a handful at some of the premier golf courses. Entry-level range is mid-30s, usually. And most golf course superintendents are making, there's a large range, but $75,000 to $125,000 a year in general. To perform at well academically, you need basic math skills, but it's only college algebra. You will need to have some chemistry, so you need to take your basic chemistry and an organic chemistry class. And of course, biology and botany. But there is science involved. It's not high level science, but most of the courses are very applied. The great thing about turfgrass management is the people that are in it. They tend to just be a close-knit group, and it's a kind of a small industry, but everybody knows each other, and so the people are fantastic. The people who actually work in turf and aren't an academic like me tend to like to do the kind of work where at the end of the day they can look back and go, look what I've done, and they can see the results every day of what they do, and it's their little piece of land, and they get to take care of it each day and provide a fantastic golf surface or football field or baseball field for others to enjoy.